The original video is on the left, and the edited video is on the right. I think this workflow does a decent job for quick editing. I am using the Wan model with the VACE module, and a new LoRA named Ditto. The LoRA is small in size, trained for editing videos, specifically with the VACE module. If it sounds complicated to you, then just continue watching. The workflow I will be showing is straightforward. I will also share all the resources with you to make it easier. Let's look at some examples. My prompt was about turning this into a Lego-style video. And you may feel this video is going faster than the original video. This is because the frame rate is higher in the result. It was a mistake and will be fixed in the next example. The number of frames in the original video is 244, out of which I have processed the first 81 frames. So I will skip the 81 frames, and now it shows 163 remaining frames. I will run the workflow to edit the next 81 frames. Processing all the frames in a single run requires a lot of graphic memory. My computer gives an error after 120 frames. I am using Sage Attention and a LiteX2V LoRA for accelerating the generation. So it took 132 seconds on my 4060 Ti 16GB card, which is fine. Now I have processed two batches of 81 frames, so I will skip the 162 frames and process the remaining frames to have the entire video. You can use any video editing software to have all the pieces of video attached together. Even comfyUI should be able to do it with the correct notes. With this video, I tried making a cyberpunk style effect. There are no objects in the background to make the neon lights, but still, some blue light effect has been added, and the apparel has been changed slightly, though it looks like some alien stuff. AI usually fails identifying the shapes in the darker areas, so this is good. But it does not work all the time. The extra hand was fixed in the second attempt. This is the pixel style of the same video, with a small defect. The defect got fixed in the second attempt. This will definitely be helpful in making videos for kids, but these tracks are not safe. Later it was fixed. Minor defects are common, but it should be fixed in the second or third attempt. I tried adding some fire, and the fire placed in the video has logic, at least it is not kept randomly in the video. I tried pointing out the train on fire, and it worked in the first attempt, but do not expect the same if there are multiple objects in the video. And painting may help in such cases. Like many Japanese anime characters, this vendetta mask was given larger, more expressive eyes. Pencil sketch video looks good. I don't know if Instagram filters work in a similar way. Let me know if you came across any other application with similar capabilities. The Ditto LoRA is compatible with a wide range of commonly used effects, whether it is pixel art or Disney Pixar style. By now, you should have a good idea of LoRA's capabilities and the kind of effects it can apply to videos. Let's look at the workflow quickly. So this section, this yellow node, deals with loading the model and other files. And in this section, I upload the original video. Here is the prompt box and the case sampler to process the workflow. And at last we get the result. Let's look at the files quickly. These are the prompt examples I was using just now. So the Wan 2.1 model is loaded here. Below is the text encoder, and then the VAE. Links to all the files are given above. I have been using the GGUF model. Below is the link to the larger models, which you can download if you have a bigger graphics card. The first link under the GGUF title should take you to the multiple GGUF models on Hugging Face. And the second link will download the Q6 model, which is the same I was using in the video. This is the link to all the larger text-to-video Wan model. If you have a larger graphics card, you can try models from this link. Next is the text encoder. There are two options, and this is the larger file. This is the FP8 file, which is smaller in size, and the same was being used in the video. The VAE has two options, and this is the file I was using in this workflow. You need to use Sage Attention with this workflow. Watch the video in the description for setting up Sage Attention. You can also avoid using Sage Attention by selecting another option here, like SDPA. Next is the LoRA. I am using two LoRAs. The first link should take you to the Ditto LoRA on Hugging Face. The second link should download the Ditto LoRA I am using to make this video. The third link should download the Light X2 V LoRA for decreasing the generation time. Both the links should download the LoRA I was using. This should help you getting started quickly. The last file is the VACE module. Similar to models, there are large files and then the GGUF files. This link should take you to the page having multiple files. And below, I have also given the file and file size, so you can download it directly and save it in the Diffusion Models folder. I have not used any of these due to the smaller graphics card. I have been using the GGUF version. This link should take you to the GGUF file page on Hugging Face. The link below is the direct download link to the file I was using in the video. Save the file in the UNED folder. The Q8 model gave better results, but I did not show the results in this video, as it was related to my personal project. Here you will be uploading the video, and this is the resize node. I have not been using this resize node because my videos were already small in size. You can type the height and width here to resize the video. The seed ID will be fixed in the workflow I will be giving you. You can change it if you are getting bad results multiple times. After the result is generated, you can add an upscaler to increase the quality of the video. So, I added a simple upscaler, and it works even on a smaller system. The images goes to the upscale image node. And using this upscale model, the same 16 FPS video is upscaled and saved. Further in this section, frames are added in the upscale video, and then this gives a 32 FPS video, which is upscaled. The video I have here does not have motion, but this workflow should produce a decent quality result. So that is it in this video. I hope you have an excellent day.